Welcome to a lesson on how to display categorical or qualitative data given in a frequency table as a bar graph, Pareto chart, pie graph, and a pictogram. Categorical or qualitative data are pieces of information that allow us to classify the objects under investigation into various categories. We usually begin working with categorical data by summarizing the data in a frequency table, where a frequency table is a table with two columns, as we see here. One column lists the categories, and the other for the frequencies with which the items in the categories occur, meaning how many items fit into each category. Looking at the frequency table, we can tell that 10 students received an A, 12 students received a B, 15 students received a C, and so on. If we sum the frequencies, we can determine the population, which we can see here would be 40, so there were 40 students in the class. Let's begin by displaying this information as a bar graph. To construct a bar graph, we need to draw a vertical axis and a horizontal axis. The vertical axis will have a scale and measure the frequency of each category. Here's our vertical axis. Notice how the largest frequency is 15, and therefore the vertical axis is scaled to 16 by 2s. The horizontal axis shows the categories. Again, here we see the letter grades. And the bar height shows the frequency. So for A, the frequency is 10. Notice how the bar has a height of 10. For B, the frequency is 12. So for B, the bar has a height of 12, and so on. Sometimes you also see the frequency listed at the top of each bar like this. Now let's talk about a Pareto chart. Sometimes our chart might benefit from being reordered from largest to smallest frequency. This arrangement can make it easier to compare similar values in the chart even without grid lines. When we rearrange the categories in decreasing frequency order like this, it is called a Pareto chart. So here's the original frequency table. If we wanted to reorder this from largest frequency to smallest frequency, we'd have to switch the A's and the C's so that the highest frequency of 15 is first, followed by 12, 10, 2, and then 1. Now if we use this frequency table to make a bar graph, it'll be a Pareto chart. So the orange graph is a bar graph. This purple graph is a Pareto chart. Again, looking at the frequencies, notice how they go from largest to smallest. So now the categories are in the order of C, B, A, D, F. And again, sometimes you will see the frequency listed at the top of each bar. Now let's display the same data as a pie chart. To show relative sizes, it is common to use a pie chart. A pie chart is a circle with wedges cut out of varying sizes marked out like slices of pie or pizza. The relative sizes of the wedges correspond to the relative frequencies of the categories. So here's the pie chart. This wedge represents the A's. This wedge represents the B's, C's, D's, and F's. Notice how this is created using software, which is very common these days, but if we had to do this by hand, one circle represents 360 degrees, so one way to determine the size of each wedge would be to use a protractor, which measures angles, and because the total number of students is 40, the sum of the frequencies, and 10 of them have A's, the letter grade of A represents 25% of the total population, or in this case, 25% of the circle. And so if we find 25% of 360 degrees, which is 90 degrees, we can measure out 90 degrees to create this wedge. And we can do the same for the other letter grades, but again, normally we just use software to create pie charts. The last graph we'll take a look at is called a pictogram. A pictogram is a statistical graph in which the size of the picture is intended to represent the frequencies or size of the values being represented. And there are some variations of pictograms. Notice here, instead of bars, we're using pictures of A's, B's, C's, D's, and F's. So it is very similar to a bar graph. Often you will see the frequency listed at the top of each picture. Notice how here the image of each letter is the same size. Another option is to stretch each image to the correct height, as we see here. A labor union might produce the graph to the right or below here to show the difference between the average manager salary and the average worker salary. Looking at the pictures, it would be reasonable to guess that the manager salaries are 4 times as large as the worker salaries, because it does appear the area of this larger bag is 4 times as large as the area of this smaller bag. However, the manager salaries are in fact only twice as large as the worker salaries, which are reflected in the picture by making the manager bag twice as tall. So here this pictogram can be deceptive unless you pay close attention to the height of each of these rather than their size. Looking at the scaling on the axes, notice how this larger bag is twice as tall as this smaller bag, representing the salaries are only twice as large, not 4 times as large. Okay, that's going to do it for this lesson. I hope you found this helpful.